Ray. People will come, Ray.
They'll come to Iowa for reasons they can't even fathom. They'll turn up your driveway, not knowing for sure why they're doing it. They'll arrive at your door, as innocent as children, longing for the past. Of course, we won't mind if you look around, you'll say. It's only $20 per person. They'll pass over the money without even thinking about it. For it is money they have, and peace they like.
Ray, just sign the papers.
And they'll walk out to the bleachers. Sit in shirt sleeves on a perfect afternoon. They'll find they have reserved seats somewhere along one of the baselines where they sat when they were children and cheered their heroes. And they'll watch the game. And it'll be as if they dipped themselves in magic waters. The memories will be so thick, they'll have to brush them away from their faces.
Ray, when the bank opens in the morning, they'll foreclose.
People will come, Ray.
You're broke, Ray. You sell now or you lose everything.
The one constant through all the years, Ray, has been baseball. America has rolled by like an army of steamrollers. It's been erased like a blackboard, rebuilt and erased again. But baseball has marked the time. This field, this game, is a part of our past, Ray. It reminds us of all that once was good, and it could be again. People will come, Ray. People will most definitely come.
Ray, you will lose everything. You will be evicted.
Higher and higher and higher they climb. saw that face and it lost all control.
Good evening, everybody, and welcome to yet another edition of the Johnny and Russ show. Here we are with all of picked, peckled and packed puree of poncy privet for you this evening.
Fuck all, geezer from fucking the good old days.
I always remember him.
Leonard Sachs.
Leonard Sachs. Brother of?
Andrew Sachs.
He was, wasn't he?
I doubt it.
He could have been. You'd never know. I think he could have been, actually. And in midstream I was. Anyway, lots of shit going on. That's what I mean to say.
Yeah.
And welcome to the Johnny and Robbo show, as I say in the the all-new Johnny and Robbo show. Jingle. What did I say, Johnny and Russ, do I? The all-new Johnny and Robbo show. Do I say that? Yeah. Anyway, good evening to you all. It's a much cooler Monday night. Although by Thursday, apparently it's going to get very hot again. Thursday's going to be a scorcher. Up to 30.
Lovely. Today I play football.
Is it? Good. Anyway, so here we are. How did your weekend go, everybody? Was it all right? Did you enjoy it? I can tell you, mine was no fucking different than any other day. In fact, I don't like the weekend.
You don't get fresh for the weekend?
Nah, fucking hate the weekend. I used to love it when I was a kid, because there was no school. Saturday morning, tell me something. When we were kids, and to wake up on a Saturday morning,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
You had your, BBC 9:25. You had your Saturday morning film. Yeah. It was either a Good Laurel and Hardy or a Norman Wisdom or a, an old black and white vintage comedy from the archives. You always guaranteed a bit, or a Bob. It was Bob Hope, or a Abbott Costello, and then of course after that you'd have your swap shop, or Saturday Superstore, and you can flick through it if there was. You'd either have a Superstore, of course, when. When Tiswas came along, it's Tiswas all the way. That took over for a long while.
Yeah.
Until they fucked that off. It was Saturdays. Actually, at first, it was Saturday's scene with Sally Beautiful Big Tits.
That's an unusual name.
Can't remember her last name. What was her name?
James.
Sally James. Saturday scene with Sally James. And that's when she used to wear all the lovely, the T-shirts. That's when you start to get the right old Sally James.
How old were you?
12? 13?
Was she?
Yeah.
I remember.
Of course. And that's when you still...
I always thought it was Noel Edmonds' beard giving you the fucking all name. Mm.
Have you seen that advert for, they come through and they interrupt, it's him, isn't it? Kevin Bacon.
Yeah.
That's a great advert, isn't it? I like Kevin Bacon. Where are you going? Yeah. What? I like Kevin Bacon. Do you? They're great adverts, I think, when he's talking about, and they walk through the deal on deal set. See that one?
Yeah.
I like Kevin Bacon.
Do you?
Yeah, he's good. Anyway.
I like Brian Sausage.
Anyway.
Michael Bubble and Squeak.
Michael Bubble and Squeak, yeah. Julie Egg. There really was a Julie Egg.
There was.
She died. Last year. 2 years ago. Lovely. She's the one, boy. Julie Egg, we have got to thank for all those years of going soon. Soon.
Well, you and Bradley.
Well, no, it was me, because it was in the terrible film called Rent a Dick. And she's going to. And she's the bit where she's doing the. Oh, my good God. When she's doing the top up, she goes, so. And I got it from that. Anyway, she's dead. And do you remember another funny, really weird film called The Seven Deadly Sins?
Yeah.
And Bruce Forsyth was in the first one, where 50p went down the
Trainwreck.
Yeah, do you remember that?
Yeah.
And there was one in it where... what's his fucking name? Oh, hello.
Terry Thomas.
No.
Leslie Phillips. Yeah.
Well, Leslie Phillips is playing this like executive.
Yeah.
And about keeping slim and not eating shit.
Yeah.
But really...
Gluttony.
But really, he keeps all his food in his... He's a real foodie, really.
Yeah.
He keeps all the bad food in a folder. He's got ham and... Do you remember that?
I remember the film. I don't remember that.
And she was... Julie Egg, rest in peace, was one of his workers. And she invites him over for dinner. Do you remember?
No.
Do you remember what a weird sketch that was? Anyway. What was I talking about?
When?
Just now. Before I'm...
Seven Deadly Sins?
No, before that.
Kevin Bacon?
Oh. Kevin Bacon, yeah, but why was I talking about Kevin Bacon? Oh, fucking hell.
Something about... On a deal or deal, no set?
Yeah, I know. I completely went off the rails. I forgot to tell you what I'm talking about. I'm sure about something.
Sally James' tits.
Ah! There we are. That's it. Saturday scene. Then, of course, came... That was the forerunner to the Tiz Was.
Yeah.
Remember?
What about Cue the Music?
That wasn't ever on in the mornings.
Yeah, that was on Saturday mornings. Mike Mansfield, Cue the Music.
That was on the late at night. That was on at 4 o'clock in the morning.
No.
And Cue the Music.
No, that wasn't. That was a Saturday morning programme.
Was it?
Yeah. Sally James hosted it.
Did she?
Yeah.
Well, I don't remember that. What's the matter with you?
I've got pain in.
What is it, like a muscle pain?
No, it's not a muscle pain. No, it is.
It's a muscle pain. Can only be that there.
I've had it for months. It's getting worse. I have to go to the fucking quack.
I have to see Valerie, but I can't.
Yeah, I have to go and see it.
Well, you obviously pulled something.
I wish.
I got that with me back.
I wish I pulled something, pal.
Some. As we're getting older, you get all these different things.
No.
Don't expect it to get any easier, because it doesn't.
No.
It's just going to get harder and harder and harder until finally...
I wish it would.
Until finally... Gone. Don't know where.
Let's not talk about death again. Just always seem to come round to death.
Well, you know, it's just... It's the one, though, isn't it? It's so fucking... It's going to happen.
Yeah.
Well, we'll discuss it.
Discuss it every day.
I do. That's what most people spend their lives just avoiding the subject.
Well, you'll be dead soon. You've had 3 cigarettes since we've been in here about 20 minutes.
There you go. I'm embracing it.
No brains, mate.
What's brains about that?
Because... Because you've got a bit of money now, John, now. 2 days' time, you won't have no money. You've got no things to pace yourself out, so you fucking make it last you a week.
Oh, shut up.
All right, but don't fucking phone me up and say I'll bring me fags round then.
All right. Bit of music, Green?
Yeah, why not?
We've got long enough? Nah, we haven't really talked about anything yet. What was I saying? Oh, yeah. Right. Yeah, no. The point I was trying to fucking make...
Yeah.
Of course. Fucking hell. You know, we used to wake up, nice film, bit of Tiz Was, bit of this, bit of that, not a bit of sport in the afternoon, not too much sport. We had the World of Sport and then Saturday Grandstand. Oh, lovely. Used to do us all. What, get the results at 5 o'clock, whatever.
Well, Grandstand now, you know, with Frank Boff, makes you wonder what he was doing when they were showing. Now we're off to show jumping in Helsinki. He fucking nipped out and fucking went down a dungeon and had a fucking sniff of fucking some
prostitute. She did?
No, some prostitute's tits and fucking had a little whipping. Then God come back up to the studio and said, yeah, there's a show jump of Helsinki. Now we're off to...
Of course he was disgraced, wasn't he?
Yeah. Now we're off to the athletics from Norway, and I'm off to the dungeon to fucking get whipped and fucking.
So easy to do.
Yeah.
Fucking idiot. Anyway, so now you get up on a Saturday morning.
Yeah.
Well, unless you're interested in cooking, you're fucked.
Well, but what? You would want to watch kids' TV, would you?
Yeah, I'd rather... Yeah! I'd not rather watch something like Chiz was, or...
Why don't you just watch CBBCs or CITES TV?
Because that is really kiddie. They got it right. They got the blend right. Because an adult could watch those shows as well.
Yeah, but now they've got dedicated channels for children.
Yeah, but you don't understand. They're not doing what they used to do. Now they just show cartoons. They didn't used to do that. It was a magazine programme of all pop stuff and pop artists coming and doing all this stuff live.
Well, that's too expensive, isn't it? That's too expensive, mate. BBC Four aren't making any drama anymore, mate. They've run out of money to make drama. Burton and Taylor was their last drama that they're making.
Fuck off.
No, I'm being serious. Being serious, pal.
That's awful.
Well, they'd rather pay the fucking management fucking £2 million fucking payoff, like the geezer who was there for about 3 weeks, and they've given him like half a bar to fucking fuck off.
Absolutely ridiculous, isn't it?
That's the problem with everything in this country, mate. The NHS, they got fucking too many middle management fucking running around earning fucking fortunes.
Yeah.
And they don't employ no fucking nurses or fucking doctors. So when you go down there, you don't see fucking anybody for fucking hours. Because fucking...
And when you do, you useless pile of shit.
Yeah, they're so run off their fucking feet, they ain't got time to fucking sit down and do anything with you.
Yeah.
Because they got to move on, because they know they've got another fucking 30 people outside waiting. And it's fucking because they've got all these middle management fucking people doing fuck all.
Mm.
And it's the same with the BBC. You've got all these management fucking people. I mean, how many people does it need to run a department of the BBC? Really? Fucking one, the head of the fucking department, really, isn't it?
Well, really, yeah.
The same with the NHS, the same with all of it. That's what's fucking wrong with this country. Too much middle management and not enough fucking troops on the fucking ground.
Mind you, you wouldn't want to be in America, would you? Anything goes wrong with you. Because if you've got any money, you don't get anything there, do you?
Well, I don't think
not to our standard, though.
Probably not to our standard, no, but I mean, well, you know, what is our standard now? Because really? We read about what goes on in hospitals.
Yeah. In fact,
you go to hospital, they want to fucking say hospitals, this is a hospital where you've got a 50% chance of fucking coming out.
Yeah.
Even if you just come in for an ingrowing fucking toenail, you might get fucking some disease that's in here.
Or we might fucking not be able to diagnose what you've got.
Wrongly diagnose,
yeah. What you came in perfectly normal, just that bird I know, she had a little back thing she had to have done. Snuff fucking died.
Yeah.
And now, of course, now they're not putting you to sleep, are they? Now you can watch your operation. It's like fucking watch your own operation, isn't it? I think they charge you a bit extra for that.
Be honest with you, the way they fuck things up, I'd rather be up watching it than fucking asleep. At least I can fucking say, oi, what are you doing, you cunt?
Well, imagine that. You know, I think once I did...
I'm coming here for an ingrown toe, man. You're trying to cut my bollocks off.
I think I did wake up once while they were doing it. I can remember it.
No, that's when Jimmy Savile was fiddling with me,
son. Oh, yeah.
You get confused with them, sir. You thought you were in an operation because he was fucking having a look up your fucking bottom. And he had a white cloak on because you were in Stoke Mandeville at the time. So you just assumed that he was a doctor. But it was Jimmy. It was Jimmy having a little fiddle about with you.
Well, as these boys say, it's a fucking mad world.
Thank you. chances grow thinner, for there's no hiding place against the kingdom's throne. So people get ready, there's a train a-coming. You don't need no baggage, you just get on board. All you need is faith to hear the diesels humming. Don't need no ticket, you just thank the
Curtis Mayfield
yeah.
ends the what was it? Curtis Mayfield and the what?
On the what? On the what?
The Impressions.
Oh, was it? Of course. He was with them first, wasn't he?
Yeah.
Oh, what do you call this fucking?
Curtis Mayfield and the Impressions there, yeah. People Get Ready, and Tears for Fears, Mad World. And we open up with, I don't normally say what we open up with, but it's Hollywood Nights by the Bob Seger Silver Bullet Band.
Mm.
And Hartley liked it, I think.
Oh, and he won't be listening now.
No, probably not. But if he is listening, you're a cunt.
Anyway.
Current Affairs with Robbo.
Well, Robbo, what have we got for us today, son?
Well, first thing's not in the papers, but the Pope likes the gays now. He likes the gays.
Oh, yeah.
He said, who is he to tell people what to do?
Well, I quite agree with
him. Well, he had to say that, really, didn't he? Considering all these Catholic priests go around fiddling with fucking choir boys. Half the Catholic priests are fucking gay, aren't
Did
they?
You see the turnout? In
3 million on Cobra Cabana Beach.
Did you fucking see it?
Well, they're a deeply religious country.
Wow.
Deeply religious,
yeah.
Catholic.
Yeah, and like most of them, they're just for the fucking spectacle.
Well, yeah, they, you know... 3 million people is fucking not a bad draw, though, is it?
That's a fantastic draw. I'll bet you some birds there, boy. Oh, my good God.
Talking about they're all nuns.
Fuck off.
They're fucking nuns, mate.
Of course they were. There's some fucking birds. Loads of birds there. Turning up the spectacle.
Well, you wouldn't have shagged any of them, though, would you?
Not in front of the boat.
No. She said, oi, your holiness, come and have a look at this one. She's fucking right. She's balls deep on me, mate. She's balls deep, boy.
Oh,
what have you got to say about that, you Argentinian
cunt?
She's jumping on my Mount Venus, pal. So, he's alright with the gays.
Ah, that's alright then.
He said, we're alright, the Catholic Church is alright with the gays.
Is it alright to...
In fact, I quote him when he says, one up the bum,
no arm down.
He said it in Argentinian, but or Latin. He said it in Latin, but very powerful when he said it.
How did it sound?
Estanius upi bummius, no homie stanius. That's how he said it. And I think this is mad. And I was a driver. You know, my job was driving.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
But they're going to lift the ban on double parking on double yellow lines.
Oh, yeah.
I think that's just asking for fucking trouble, that is.
Yeah, you got done enough.
Yeah, I mean, all right, maybe if you're delivering. If you're just gonna put your car on a double yellow line for 20 minutes and just go into a shop and come out with a bag, you know, how many people are going to do that? They're going to clog up the fucking road. The road, surely, it'd be hard to get past. Say you've got a thing with two double yellow lines.
Why are they going to lift the ban?
I'll tell you right now when this comes on.
I wonder why that is. Seems a strange thing to do, doesn't it?
It is. Drivers will be able to park on double yellow lines for 15 minutes under proposals to boost trade in high street shops. Community Secretary Eric Pickles, fat cunt, wants to introduce a grace period that will allow motorists to pop into local shops without being hit by hefty penalties.
Well,
high fines could be introduced outside London for motorists who park dangerously. Well, maybe. Maybe it will work then.
They had to do something, son. It's getting ridiculous, wasn't it?
They make such a lot of money, though, didn't they, from the parking fines?
Not half. Fucking right they do. What's that?
Nothing.
Who's that? What is that?
It's a joke. Right, what's in the old paper?
What the fuck's going on here?
Coronation Street has been caught in a new scandal after plugging a theatre show on TV. 8 million fans saw character Roy Cropper left say he had tickets to Midnight Tango, a real-life production starring Strictly's Flavia's something.
More like her Flavia.
His actor friend, her actor fiancé, Jimmy Mystery, is joining Corey. So what? If they're advertised, they're so fucking what? Let them all fucking advertise if they want to fucking advertise.
Who's that?
That's Kim from Newcastle. Newcastle?
Oh, Kim. You see what I mean? They think just putting a little fluffy out on her and just it all just take. Ah, oh, look, she's all right. Is it? No, she's not. He's got her fucking tits out.
What's that like?
Who cares?
Be a fucking mass murderer out there.
No. Mass murderer, my ass.
You know, there's this thing, the co-op. You see what the co-op are doing?
No.
They want lads made.
Oh, I've seen it. They've done it.
No, they haven't done it.
Yeah, they've got it. Yeah, I've seen it.
They haven't done it yet. They want 6 weeks. They've given them 6 weeks to sort it out.
No, they give them. That's it. They've been given the go-ahead. Lads mates have got to have covers on them.
What do you mean with a go-ahead? They don't need a go-ahead. The co-op decide that they want it like that.
Oh, I see. Yeah, they're going to do it.
Not a government thing. It's the co-op's decided to do it.
It's the co-op.
Yeah.
What do you think?
Well, it's better, you know, it's not pornography, is it? I mean, we're all just a little bit over fucking hyped about fucking pornography in this country.
Well, don't tell me about it, son. You try and explain it to people, they just do not get it.
You know, they say that things like lads mags play and also Playboy and all the dirty mags lead to dirty thoughts and everything.
Oh, for God's sake.
I've got news for you, folks. The thing that leads to dirty thoughts is having a fucking cock. That's the thing that leads to dirty thoughts.
Well, I don't understand what they're talking about. I mean, what are they trying to say? I thought we'd grown up. I thought everyone had grown up sexually and realised that men wank. All right? And whether they've got anything to fucking wank over or not, they will wank. They will always wank. It's part of fucking... I wish I still did, but I don't anymore.
It's just they just want to take these people. I don't know what's wrong with these fucking people. So, Loading Magazine has got a picture of a bird with a bikini on. If you go past fucking OK Magazine, it's got a picture of a bird with a bikini on.
Go on the beach.
I think they want it to go back to like the 1930s, some people. They really do.
I'm sure about the ankle.
You know, it's just fucking shit. People get on my fucking tits.
Ugh. You know what's done it? It's the child abuse that's done it. And they're still calling it child pornography. It is not, as you said, pornography. It's nothing to do with pornography. It's child abuse. And that's all there is to it.
Yep.
And they've got to fucking realise it.
It's fucking just, you know, it's mental to be honest with you. It's fucking mental. Just want, you know, to do that. Fucking, it's not pornography loaded and fucking nuts and zoo. They're shit. Don't get me wrong, they're shit magazines. But it's not pornography.
It's nowhere near pornography.
You won't find no minge on display there.
No.
You won't find no cunt on there unless they're doing a fucking interview with Russell Brand.
Anyway, they're all cunts who write for those magazines. They're pricks. They're arseholes. They haven't got a clue what the fucking real... What's on the pulse. They don't get it right. They don't mix it right. They think you want to read about sport all the time. No, we don't. Not just because we're men. It doesn't mean that you just want to... If you're reading on a lad's mag, the last thing you want to do is read about sport. You get your own magazines for sport.
I don't want to read about sport. I don't want to read about cars.
No, cars. Fucking cars. It was a great gag in her. Frasier the other day. When he has the... He's got this Jewish woman and her mother over. And she's told her mum that Frasier's Jewish.
Yeah.
And when they started talking about cars or something to do with the cars, oh, it was a great gag. I can't remember it now. That's a great program, Frasier.
Brilliant.
Remember that one?
Yeah, I do remember that one. Yeah.
There's one today with Niles. Niles loses it, loses the plot, and undresses in the...
Yeah, I remember that. I would always watch a Frasier, though.
Oh, yeah.
Well, here's one. This is just a quick one. NHS bosses paid out $30 million in pensions over 10 years to ex-workers who had died. That's exactly what I was saying before. That's what's fucking... And it's a little thing in the fucking paper, like it's a joke thing. They've just wasted $30 million of the NHS's money in pensions paying people who had died.
Did you tell me about someone who was making money out of people who were dead? Making clothes for them.
Yeah, that was last night.
Yeah, well, that's incredible, isn't it? I couldn't get over that.
Why can you get over it?
Well, it's incredible. Making clothes for the dead. It's morally wrong, isn't it?
Well, nothing morally wrong about it.
No?
No, nothing morally wrong. So if you're going to die and you want to buy some of their clothes... Nothing wrong with it. If you want to be buried in a nice suit or, you know, a nice dress or whatever.
I suppose not. I suppose it's the same thing as putting on the coffin, isn't it?
Yeah, it's just part of the buying whatever, you know, whatever you buy.
Yeah.
Me, I want to go in a biodegradable box.
Yeah.
I'm fucking stuffed. I told you, I'm stuffed on the centre circle of Spurs. You'd have to play round me. Here's a pathetic story, people, that is of no interest to anybody whatsoever.
Right.
Kim Kardashian and Kanye West avoided giving their daughter a name beginning with K to avoid being labelled KKK.
Well, damn.
The initials of white supremacist Ku Klux Klan. Instead, the reality star and rapper opted for Northwest for their firstborn. Kim writes that our kid, if it's a K, they'll call us KKK. What a pathetic story.
Yeah.
What an absolutely pathetic fucking story.
Well, it is pathetic, I must say.
So Bruce Forsyth banked a Brucey bonus last year, swelling his earnings to nearly $6 million. Figures show the Strictly Come Dancing legend's personal business, through which he funnels his TV and commercial work, pulled in almost $1 million more than the previous year.
No.
Bruce Forsyth Enterprises reported £5,766,817 cash in October 2012, up from $4 million in July 2011. The 15-month period was a busy one for Brucey. He earned $500,000 for Strictly and starred in Morrison's Christmas TV ads. He also released album These Are My Favourites. What does he need that much money for fuck's sake? How old is he? 80-odd?
86, 84.
He'll be dead before the end of the year.
Do you reckon?
No. But what's he need that money for?
Well, for his grandchildren and...
Fuck them.
That's what I say. What's that?
What?
Locker? That was Russell's fucking stupid game.
I'm stupid about that. Parents are being told to spend up to £500 on iPads for their kids ahead of the new school year. More and more schools are making the costly request as polls show pupils like learning with electronic tablets. Heads also insist using them will save money on notepads and pens in the long run. But teaching unions yesterday warned the trend could lead to a classroom digital divide for kids that cannot afford them. Quite right.
Fucking hell. Jesus.
How much does an iPad cost?
About 400 quid.
What do they think that people are made of fucking money all the time or something?
You fucking... They're expensive iPads. They're great. It's exactly what we need.
Yeah, well, fuck off.
For Springer.
What do you mean? Why do we need it?
Well, it's perfect. Just...
Why?
Well, it's just a bit more mobile.
What do you mean?
Be anywhere and do it.
Still wouldn't be a good sound, though, would it?
What do you mean, sound?
Well, you wouldn't be on it.
But it's, for them it's the same. For the audience. I mean, we wouldn't be getting the no. Well, yeah, we're still plugging to them. We would sit here with it like that. And,
yeah,
well,
we ain't going to buy one, are we, so...
Yeah, we are.
I mean, yeah, we are. Well, how are you going to buy that?
Oh, I'll have plenty of money this year.
What?
Yeah.
Talking about...
I've got corporate plans.
Yeah? Yeah? In your fucking head, you've got plans.
No.
What plans have you got?
What about us, boy? Vegas next year. Oh, yeah. This is just a little lull, boy.
Yeah?
Yeah. It's a little lull, son. It's nothing. Be back to normal soon.
Yeah?
Yeah.
So what about that?
Oh, what are you doing? Selling your cock?
Ah, I think you saw that. What do you think that are useful?
Well, you're selling bits of your body for medical research. They have a field day with you, son. Chop your legs off, they could fucking run the London Hospital School for fucking 100 years on your legs.
Feed a few people.
No,
more calves.
They can just fucking discover fucking unknown diseases within them.
Don't you worry, boy.
It's all allowed.
Have a bit of cake, Bush.
Have a bit of...
I saw it burn. a sound you hear that lingers in your ear, but you can't forget from sundown to sunset. Now, now, it's all in the air, you hear it everywhere. No matter what you do, it's gonna grab a hold on you. California soul, California soul. You see the sun comes up every morning, and if you listen oh so carefully, the winds that ride on the high tide whistle. It's really such a groove now. Puts a brand new kind of thinking in your mind, and you can't go wrong, cause you're grooving all day long. California soul, California soul. You have a melody and the beat, y'all.
Of course, that was the end. When you hear the bass and just boom, 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 boom. That's where they must have got the idea for Rapper's Delight and Sugarhill Gang. Hey, hip, hop, hip, 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 hop, you don't stop.
I wonder what's first, that or Rapper's Delight?
That.
What year was that?
79.
So was Rapper's Delight.
I think you'll find.
I think that was first, but that was Chic.
Chic.
Chic. Not shit. Chic.
Chic.
Good times.
Good times, Terry.
Before that, we had. Well, we started that one off with Them Heavy People by Kate Bush. Yep. Very influential singer as well.
Mmm. And, it was.
One in the middle was California Soul by.
Marlena Shaw.
Marlena Shaw.
There have been other versions, a lot of other versions of California Soul, but not ever as good as that.
No, that's the original.
Oh, yes.
That's the original, therefore.
Marvin Gaye did a version of it.
Marvin Gaye did do a version of it.
That's the one.
But Marlena Shaw is the version, I feel. I feel it's the version. I feel it's the right version to play.
You're absolutely right, son.
Go on, son, you're doing well.
Go on, son, you're doing well. It's quite out there tonight, I think.
Wonder why that is.
Well, it's a Monday night, boy.
Yeah.
Monday nights is quiet, aren't they? Well, they come in, though. They listen.
Do they?
Yeah, boy.
Don't know about that, your slag on a rag.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Yeah?
No. So,
that dick of yours,
that dick of mine, it's very big. Very, very powerful.
It's a powerful old unit.
It is. You bought all the sun a bit, bro?
I did on Saturday, yeah. Yeah, I did on Saturday.
Didn't you?
I spent all day in Hyde Park, didn't I?
Nice and brown, didn't you?
Well, you know, it don't take me long to catch the sun, mate. I'm a sun magnet.
Catch the rays, did you?
Caught a few rays, son.
Yeah.
Caught a few rays of the new
version. Who was you out with? A few mates.
A couple of people.
Oh, yeah.
A couple of the old firm.
The old drug dodgers.
The old drug dodgers, yeah. Out with them and... plenty of birds about in Hyde Park.
I'm not being a drug dodger, I'd say that. I'm all for it. Oh, I couldn't think of anything worse.
Than what?
Taking drugs. Well, let's fight.
Drugs feel good.
Look, me and you are sitting here now, and we've survived quite an awful lot in our lives.
He said lighting up a drug.
Yeah, it's all right, it's fair, isn't it? We've survived, God, quite a lot.
Well, I've survived, you know, I don't like to talk about it. I'm a bit like Russell Brand like that. I don't like to talk about it. But now I will talk about heroin for the next half an hour.
Yeah.
That's what Russell Brand would do. I don't like to talk about it, but I'm just going to talk about heroin for the next half an hour. And then I'm just going to go up to the fucking Houses of Parliament and talk about heroin again. Then I'm going to go on on Question Time and talk about heroin again.
Yeah.
But I don't like to talk about it.
No, you like to keep it quite sort of hush-hush, didn't you?
I like to keep it to myself, you know? Fucking, that's the worst thing, isn't it? That cunt still ain't on heroin. I'll fucking even pay for it.
He'd be alright. Churn out another few fucking films.
Another fucking live DVD video would come out.
You haven't seen these films, have you?
No.
I saw Arthur. I was bored one morning.
Oh, yeah.
Ugh. Poor Dudley, he must have been absolutely rolling about in his grave.
Thing is, if Dudley was alive, he would have had a cameo in that film.
Yeah, he probably would have done, yeah. I would have embraced it, he'd have embraced it.
Yeah.
Same with like Freddie Mercury would have done the same things. People like that do.
What do you mean? What would he have embraced?
Well, I don't know, some naff things a bit would do.
It was a bit different, he'd still be in Queen, wouldn't he, if he was still alive?
Do you reckon?
Well, they'd be going in some shape or form.
He would have stopped, would he?
No. No.
He would have stopped.
He would have carried on going as far as his fucking arse could carry him, mate. Which, with all the cock he's had, not long. Not far at all.
No, he had a lot of cock.
Did he?
Cock.
Well, I said that, did he?
Yeah, he admitted it, though, didn't he?
Admitted it?
Yeah.
He could not but admit it, could he?
Well, that man has been taking up the arse a lot.
Yeah.
It's Roger Taylor, who is so blatantly straight. How he got on with it, because he is so... Did you ever see the... Oh, my God. I must get it up, see if I can find it. It's when Freddie passed. About the day after, I think. Mike Norris, was it? Who was it? He used to be on daytime TV. He's dead now. He died last week. Mike Norris.
Is that your sole purpose of this show? Just to go through people who are dead?
Mike Norris, do you remember him? He's the one that...
Mike Morris.
He's the one... Do you remember when they lost the franchise to... And he came in and went, I am gutted!
Yeah.
He's dead.
He's not gutted now.
No, he's dead. But he was asking...
I've seen it. Paul Daniels and Queen, the two, Brian May and... I don't think it was 2 days after he died. I think they were publicising the Freddie Mercury concert.
Yeah. And he said to Paul Daniels and says... Was you a fan of Queen? No, not at all, no. You couldn't stand it. But, you two know, when I was doing my magic, and that's all I wanted. It was nothing to say with you, was it? What a cunt.
Well, he's been honest, wasn't he?
Oh, he was being more than honest.
Well, he's been honest, though. You think didn't like the music. That's fair enough to say, isn't it?
Not like that, you don't.
No, I thought it was fair enough to say.
Did you?
What, you want him to sit there? I don't want him to sit there.
What a horrible man!
Well, I'm sure he is a horrible man, I could only wish death on him. But.
No, I'm sorry. I'm not
having. I don't mean that was particularly terrible, what he said there.
See, what is terrible? I've got time with it.
We still on?
Yeah.
Where do you know? If you can't type anything, the whole thing might be down.
No,
roll out the ball.
Oh, look, we're still on.
Well, it's a one for the money and a two for the show. Three to get ready and fuck go. Don't you? Step on my big fat balls. You can do anything but lay off of my big fat balls. You can slap my cock. You can kick my teeth. Slander my dick all over the place. Do anything you want to do, but honey, lay off of my balls. Don't you? Step on my big fat balls. There's a new rendition for you of the Fergus Elvis song, Blue Suede Shoes. Blue Suede Balls.
All right.
Well, it's a blue suede balls, baby. A blue suede balls, baby. A blue suede shoes. You can do anything but lay off of my big black balls. Well, thank you.
It's still working, Paul.
Yeah, shut up.
Look at that.
Play a song and try and work it out what you're doing.
Yeah.
He don't know what he's doing. I don't know what I'm doing. The pair of us don't know what we're doing. Rather like, here's a bit of 60s pop for you.
Smokey Robinson and the Miracles, The Tracks of My Tears. We had From Milk and Honey, John Lennon, Grow Old With Me. Unfortunately, nobody grew old with him.
No, he didn't grow old at all.
And we started...
Best thing, really.
Yep. And we started that off with the Spencer Davis Group, and I'm a Man. And I am a man.
I'm a man, don't you know?
And I'll prove it. I'll prove it. I've got the cup to prove it.
To prove it.
Here we go. I was telling you yesterday about the woman who had been threatened with rape for wanting Jane Austen on the back of a £10 note.
Yeah.
Seems quite strong to me.
Well, it's very strong.
Banknote campaigner Caroline Criado Perez was hit by a new barrage of sick abuse last night. It came hours after cops arrested a man on suspicion of sending her rape and death threats on Twitter.
Yeah.
Caroline has received 600 sick tweets in 12 hours for her petition to put writer Jane Austen on the £10 note. But after Scotland Yard confirmed a 21-year-old man had been arrested in Manchester on suspicion of harassment, Caroline retweeted messages from a troll who set up the account Rape Her Now.
A troll?
A troll who set up an account called Rape Her Now.
Oh.
The feminist campaigner, whose petition received more than 35,000 signatures, yesterday launched a crusade for button on button to report abuse on Twitter. She has 20,000 backers, including the celebrity's MP.
Hmm.
I mean, who would set up an account called Rape Her Now? I mean, for fuck's sake, what is fucking wrong with fucking people in this fucking world? They just can't get on. She wants fucking Jane Austen on the back of a £10 note. She don't want to fucking kill anybody. She's not fucking saying put loaded in a fucking paper bag. All she wants is fucking Jane Austen on the back of a £10 note.
What do you think about it? Well, you're fucked, did you? Who do they want on the back of a £10 note?
What does it matter?
Matters fuck all to me.
I mean, do you know who's on the back of a £10 note now?
Dickens.
No, years ago, Dickens ain't on it now.
Who's on it now?
I don't know, but it's not Dickens.
Oh, Dickens was not still on there.
No. Years ago he went.
Why did he go?
Well, they changed it, didn't they?
Jay asked him. Don't you see, well, if it fucking J.K. Rowling, I'll go butt out.
Well, you know, they haven't, I think they only had dead people on the back of it.
Oh, do they?
Yeah. I think the new £5...
Mel Smith?
I think the new £5 going to have Winston Churchill.
He's been on there, hasn't he? No. He's a murderer, yeah? Well.
And Jane Austen on the new £10.
Hmm.
And my cock on the new £20.
Oh, yeah. That's the one I'm looking forward to.
Yeah. You won't mind handling that, will you?
No, boy. I want plenty of 20s. I want a score.
With my door.
Yeah.
You whore.
Yeah.
Well, I think it's all a bit overreacting.
Well, absolutely.
But I think anybody who sets up a Twitter thing called Rape Her Now, let's see if we can find him. Let's see what little pearls of wisdom he's fucking coming up with.
Reckon. Take a good look at my face. You see my smile looks out of place.
How'd you look for people in this fucking
world? I don't know. I don't ever use it. Ever use that? Oh, no, I don't know how to use that at all. Is she playing with the tits?
Yeah. She just, there just happened to be a, what's her name there?
Yeah. She's a cunt, that bird. Oh, you? Look at those tits. Yeah. Yeah, don't you filthy fat.
Yeah, this don't make very good radio if you're fucking reading the paper.
I'm just looking at her tits. Make a good look at my face. 3 days to go. So what?
Can't find it. Can't find Rape Her Now on the Twitter. Which is a great shame.
Can't find it.
No.
No.
He's obviously.
Oh, I like spanking, boy, boy, boy. Up and down until I get a pain in me groin. I try to me at me, and when it really counts, I turn into a rubber ball and bounce, bounce, bounce. Hey! What's the matter with all of you?
Absolute fucking toe rag.
Oh, fucking hell, my leg hurts.
Good.
It's a cunt. It's a cunt, I'll tell thee. It's a cunt, I'll tell thee. Oh. Whining Hall.
Yeah, paedophile broadcaster Stuart Hall has vowed, I will not die in prison. Shame. The disgraced 83-year-old whined that jail was living hell, but said he would stay strong for his family. Hall, who last week had his 15-month sentence doubled after judges ruled it was too soft, plans to be a model prisoner in the hope of an early release.
Yeah.
The married dad of two, jailed for sexually assaulting 13 victims aged 9 to 17, said, I will take what's coming to me. That's what they said. The former It's a Knockout presenter opened up to a pal at Preston Prison. There's always a pal.
Yeah.
A pal at Preston Prison.
There's a pal there.
How has he got a pal in Preston Prison? How has he got a pal?
Another pedo pal. He's got a pedo pal, hasn't he?
Well, it's all the friends you need is a pedo pal. The friend then confided in a relative who told the son.
Yeah! That's it, you tell Peter, play Paul, that is.
Yeah. Hall lives every day. The geezer's gone to prison and said, oh yeah, that's Stuart Hall's in here. He was telling me he's going to survive. And the geezer's come out there and gone, get me the number of the son rather quickly because I feel they're going to pay for this story.
Yeah.
They've probably given him, what, 200 quid for this information, probably?
More.
You think so? No.
Yeah.
I reckon about 200 they paid him for that.
Yeah?
Yeah, it's not a big story here, is it?
You're on.
Hall lives every day in fear of attack, despite being frail and unsteady on his feet. He plays the sick old man card perfectly,
to make people feel sorry for him, but mentally he is still very sharp and knows how to play the prison system. Most of the inmates think he's a sad, dirty old man and can't be bothered to talk to him, but some of the younger guys bang on his cell as they walk past, calling him a nonce.
Yeah!
He just sits in the corner of his cell, staring at the four walls, or lying on the bottom of the bunk for hours on end. It's great, isn't it?
Oh, it's fantastic. Fucking serves that cunt right. I thought they'd get away with it for years.
We did.
Yeah? But they thought we'd get away with the rest of his life.
He thought he could take it to his grave, mate. And he didn't.
Yeah, well, he doesn't think he did any wrong.
No, he probably don't. He probably don't think he was wrong at all.
Apparently there was a proper nonce. A real lecher with all women.
Who?
Hole.
Yeah.
He was a strange man. Strange man when me and Bell met him at the... when we did that Poet Laureate thing.
Yeah.
And we did Football Focus. It was never shown because...
he nonced you.
He nonced us. That was never shown. Football Focus.
Yeah.
Come on.
What?
The burp.
There was no burp.
It was coming.
It wasn't. I was just moving.
No, you get ready for the burp, I saw you. I know that moving. Face anywhere.
I was moving.
Ah. And at the end of the show, that was never shown. He did a poem. And from there, we're done to do. And da 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 da. And he came, he had to be in the middle of me and Bell. So I'm standing one side and Bell standing the other to the camera. And he smelled weird. Remember that?
What did he smell like? Sex?
I don't know. He smelled very weird.
Nonsense.
It's weird. And probably, I mean, we had to do a thing to the camera, which was, we had to go like that and walk off. But I remember saying to Bill, Aldridge, what a weird man. He was a weird man. And now he's there.
So why wasn't it shown?
Ah, because in the week...
Shit.
Because in the week...
Yeah.
Whoever... idiots. Got us on the Channel 4 show to do this poet. It was for the Poet Laureate. Do you remember the... people had to write the best team song. For their like West Ham or so, I can't remember who won it now. But we did it on Football Focus. They thought they had the exclusive.
Yeah.
But then in the week, we'd gone on Channel 4 and did it for Channel 4 News. So Football Focus went, fuck you. We're not going to show it. We're gutting because Football Focus is the best one. Channel 4 News was shit.
Stuart was happy because he thought, well, I'm not on Football Focus, I can go and do a bit of fucking nonsense.
Yeah.
I was going to wait in and watch myself on Football Focus, but I'm not in. Let me go down and fucking tell a girl I can get her on the telly and...
There's Stuart and us on the fucking programme as well.
Jimmy Savile?
Your favourite boy.
Who?
Chris Miles. Oh, we spent the day with that cunt. I told the story before.
Yeah.
We stood there drinking all day with him and him going, all just to get him to play the record. That was all we wanted him to do. And at the end of it, he's gone, I'm going to play your record. I'm going to play your record. A couple of morning, I had to listen to this, folks. I had to listen to 2.5 hours of that. Come on.
Yeah.
Didn't fucking mention it. Arsehole. And then, about a year and a half later, something like that, the Soccer Six. Yeah, the Soccer Six. We were in Iron Maiden's team. And I was managing them. I wasn't really, but... It was good fun. Great, great, great bunch of lads. And Iron Maiden got through to the final with the Radio 1 team.
Yeah.
And who's managing the Radio 1 team? Cunt Miles.
Yeah.
Right? I went up to him in the middle of the pitch. I said, thanks for playing our fucking record. Went, oh, you don't still think about that, do you? I said, well, yeah. Anyway, we're going to fucking stuff you. And we did. We were under Iron Maiden won the trophy that year. That's when Gazza was there. And he was giving out the medals, you know.
Yeah.
And he was so lovely.
Pissed?
No, he wasn't pissed. Fragile. very fragile. I mean, literally, you're there, so you're sitting there now, and I was standing there, and he was like there, and I was watching him. Can't think of it now. Watching him try and do a
stand
few
up.
Well, yeah. Well, he's just trying to do a few tricks, and it was awful to watch. Just to think, you know, what he was.
What was he?
A brilliant footballer. And that 1990 magic coming up when I come home and.
Yeah.
To think
we had a parade for a team that finished in the semi finals. Brilliant.
No, I'm not talking about that. I'm not talking about
that. Let's have a parade.
I'm not talking about. I'm not
winning the fucking competition.
I'm not talking about the England football team. I'm talking about we had the player that everyone was talking about. Talk about Spurs.
We still have now.
Yeah, I know.
We have now, and we're going to get rid of him as well.
We ain't going to get rid of him. But we had
the one we got now is better than Gazza.
Mm. Well, he is, yeah. And we had. And that match, I'll never forget that match. The first match of the season. I mean, it was on everybody's. Everyone wanted him. And we had him. What a buzz. Did you go to that match?
No.
No, you wouldn't take hold of them, would you?
No.
That's what I thought back to. It was that match, that first. Who did we play? No, I thought you might remember. It was that. I remember sitting there watching the fucking Sky Sports, whatever it was, and
place. It was Sky Sports.
It wasn't them days.
They didn't have the football in them days.
Didn't
there
they?
There was no live football in them days.
It was. Oh yes, there was, boy.
Yeah, once ITV would have it on a. Sunday, one game on a Sunday.
It was definitely live, it was, that game. That game was live. Gazza's first game of the season. It was a Sunday, right. And, yeah, Sunday, that's right. Sundays would only be a live game, wouldn't it?
Yeah.
Mid-90s, that would started. The
92.
92, was it? But, yeah. But he was so lovely, though. Such a nice gentleman.
Oh, yeah.
There we are.
Who would know that fucking 6 years later he'd turn up at Rail Moat with a fucking bit of fried chicken saying I can help him? And I think he had a point. I think if they'd let him go there with a bit of the Kentucky he had, it might have calmed the old situation down. And Rail Moat might have good. You know what? What am I doing here? What am I doing? Having a standoff with the police, and come out, and it would have been, and Gazza would have been the hero. But no, they had to think that he was pissed.
I think they did the right thing. Fucking lunatic.
Well, don't underestimate the fucking chicken burger, mate. Don't underestimate it.
What did he say, Gazza? He said, "Oh, good."
I'm going to sit down and have a bit of chicken with him. He's a good lad.
He didn't even know him.
Somewhere in his fucking pickled brain, he thought he did know him.
Terrible.
Imagine being that fucking far gone that you actually think that you know Raoul Mo.
Oh. What if there's a picture of what's wrong? I can't get online here. Iron Maiden. Sucker. There you go. It's me. What was that behind there?
Oh well, there should be. Should have, could have, would have, mate. Who's the bird playing with her tits out?
What?
More to the point.
All right, there you go. Look, look. Yeah. Can't. Good day that was. There we are.
Do you say that's the greatest day of your life?
Oh yes.
More great than when your first born was born.
Eh?
More great than when your first born was born.
Yeah, that little cunt.
Yeah, that little cunt.
Fuck him.
Fuck, you should have shoved him back up.
Oh, that little prick.
Come out, does it? Come out like a fucking cunt, didn't he, that geezer? Yeah. He turned into one as well.
Oh, we're back in there, look, it's alright.
Pay off, pup.
What was I looking for before?
God knows. That's
I know what it was. It was Queen.
Yeah, look, this is good for us. The first disposable £1 e-cigarette was set to go on sale today. Its manufacturer claims the Easy Cig lasts up to 220 puffs, roughly equal to a pack of 20 cigs. I'll tell you what, that's not bad, is it? I think I might fucking go for some of that. Just don't give you that hit though, does it?
What's that? Yeah. No. No, it does not. We mean the artificial one?
Yeah.
It does give you a little bit of a hit, doesn't it?
Yeah, it does. I know a couple of people who have been out of stock with them.
Really?
I couldn't do it, though.
Why not?
No, why not? You can.
I can feel. Really?
I mean, really, you didn't as well, you can't.
No, I tried, didn't I? It's expensive as well.
What is?
But, isn't it?
Not as expensive as cigarettes.
No. But apparently they're not very good for you. They've proven something, haven't they?
I don't know if they've proven it, but I don't know. Yeah, something about it. But I know people have given up with it.
Well, they stay on that.
Yeah.
No. It's beautiful.
Yeah. Pop pedo Gary Glitter has raked in 1 million of royalties after Oasis used a clip of one of his hits it was claiming.
Told you that. Right.
The Shane Glam rocker will continue to earn pots of cash for many years from Oasis track Hello. Yeah. It is the opening song on What's the Story Morning Glory and includes the lyric Hello, Hello, It's Good to Be Back.
Yeah.
From Glitter's 1973 hit Hello, Hello, I'm Back Again.
That's right.
The 1995 Oasis album has sold 22 million worldwide. Glitter, 69, real name Paul Gadd, gets a payment for each album sold or when the song is played on the radio or internet. Not if we played it, he wouldn't. He is entitled to the cash as he's still credited as the co-writer of Hello, despite receiving an estimated $200,000 for copyright infringement after taking legal action against Oasis in 1999. Music lawyer Craig Brooks said Hello could have earned Glitter $1 million on top of $300,000 a year or more from royalties linked to his back catalogue of songs. He said it's distasteful, but sadly he is legally entitled to the money. Despite being an awful human being, Glitter was jailed for 4 months in 1999 for downloaded child porn. In 2006, he was caged in Vietnam for molesting two girls. He served almost 3 years. Nice fella.
What gets me is, he was a known paedophile. Still, he does it again. He gets only 3 years.
Well, that was in Vietnam.
Mind you, let's face it. It's hardly child abuse, is it?
What?
But no. It's only Vietnamese kids.
Yeah.
they look like wrongs anyway.
It is a wedding do you would have liked to have gone to, John. Mm-hmm. Newlywed fast food fan Stephen and Emily Asher held their reception at McDonald's.
Wow.
The besotted couple with 33 guests dined together in a roped off area at a branch where the pair met for dates before deciding to tie the knot.
Emily, 21, tucked into a £4.29 chicken McNugget meal, and Stephen, the £5.09 chicken legend option, washed down with a strawberry milkshake. Stephen, 28, splashed out £150 on the grub at the Mackie D's in Cribbs, Causeway, Bristol. His bride said, "I did get quite a few people staring at me at McDonald's, but I didn't care. You fucking chav cunt."
Oh, my God. What a pair of cunts.
What a pair of fucking chav fuckers having their wedding reception in fucking McDonald's for £150. You fucking tight cunts.
You'd be saying that, wouldn't you?
Huh?
If you were invited, you'd be saying
well,
that.
Well, I wouldn't go, would I? If somebody invited me, I mean, I wouldn't go to a wedding
reception. Well, hang on a second, though. McDonald's is lovely.
No, yeah, it's shit, though, isn't it?
Yeah, but it's great.
But it's shit.
Be free Donald's, boy. Free Donald's.
No. I mean, I wouldn't go if somebody invited me to a fucking wedding reception at the fucking Ritz. If I could get out of it, I wouldn't go. But if somebody invited me to a wedding reception at fucking McDonald's, I definitely wouldn't fucking go.
I want to see the other way around me. I wouldn't go to the Ritz. Fuck the Ritz. I don't want to go there.
No, I wouldn't go to the Ritz.
Give me some free Donald's. I'm there.
I would just try and get out of going to any wedding reception possible.
Well, go and get me Donald's, though, it's takeaway.
Yeah, so cheers, I'm off. Have a happy marriage, you fucking idiots. This is what's going to happen for the rest of your fucking lives. And sit there eating fucking shit.
I can't have lost my Donald's. Months. Months. Three months. Must be 3 4 months, 3 months. I love Donald's. But, you know, you look at, like, people look at the side and go, "Oh, you must eat fucking loads of shit." Or, I don't.
No, but you have in the past.
In the past?
Well, there you go then.
But not for years.
Well, you just haven't shifted it, though, have you? You don't do no exercise.
No.
You fucking sit on your fucking...
Well, I can't exercise.
Well, you could have 5 years ago.
Yeah, I should have done, yeah.
You could have 5 years ago, only now you can't. Don't fucking use that as an excuse, you cunt.
Mm.
You've had plenty of time to exercise. But I'll tell you what it is. You're one lazy fucker.
Well, I'll agree with that.
I speak as a fine, mate. I speak as a fine.
No, no, no. I'll agree with you wholeheartedly there, boy. I am one lazy piece of shit.
If you were exercising 5 years ago, you wouldn't have the problems you're having.
No, I needed to. Folks, please use me as a
yardstick.
As a yardstick. Exercise is important.
You know, not a lot. Not a lot. I'm not saying go and fucking run a marathon.
Oh, I've been very lazy.
I'm just saying, you know, go for a walk.
Telly.
All he does is sit in front of the telly all day long.
Well, not now, I don't.
Well, what do you do?
I'll tell you why, because I can't sit too long.
Well, yeah, but that's all he did do, was sit in front of the telly, smoke.
And eat.
And eat. And now look at the fucking way, the way he is. So let that be a lesson to you. Let that be a lesson to you as well. You too could have a body like him.
Yeah.
If you don't do fuck all.
Mm.
Or you can have a body like mine, if you do nothing but got a very high metabolism.
Well, no, you...
Eat absolute crap and got a very high metabolism.
You exercise, though.
Get some exercise. Well, I did through work, but see, I have stopped work. I don't really exercise that much now.
No, you don't eat properly, do you? My goodness me.
Best one's my old man. He had... he had two... Well, imagine, for dinner, for lunch, he had two bits of toast with butter on it, and then he was eating dinner tonight, and his dinner was comprised of Philadelphia on crackers. That was what he was eating. My mum was going, "Look what he's eating! Look what it's not normal!" I had to agree with her, it's not fucking normal.
Wow. But he's all right, though.
Well, I don't know. Who knows, mate? Who knows? He's not fucking right, is it? You shouldn't be eating like that.
Why does he eat like that?
I don't know.
Does he not like food at all?
Yeah, I think he does.
Does he not get hungry or think, "Oh, fancy lighter"?
I don't know, perhaps he sees it as a fucking test of his manner to see how fucking hungry he can get. Or he's not well and he's not getting hungry. And he's not telling anybody he's not well.
How long has this been going on?
Ages.
What, years?
Yeah.
Well, sorry, it really ain't to do with him not being well, because I think he... My mum's the same. My mum, she doesn't eat much at all. She has a few shreddies, about 10:30.
Oh, you don't have breakfast?
No lunch.
You don't have breakfast?
Oh, don't eat now. My mum's no lunch.
You'll have two bits of toast for lunch.
No lunch. Then she'll have a bit of dinner, and she'll leave most of it. That's it.
Amazing.
But she's not skinny.
She's not fat.
No, she's not fat, no. But she's not skinny, though. You look at her, she's not skinny.
No, she's not skinny.
She's not skin and bone, is she? Not a skinny little woman.
No.
Yeah, she fucking hardly eats, boy. You don't eat much, though. You'll have a little pizza for dinner, won't you? Worry, one of you good fellas.
I don't eat that every day, you cunt.
What'd you have tonight?
Cottage pie.
Ooh. Out of the packet?
Yeah.
Tesco's?
Mark's.
Oh, a Mark's one?
Yeah.
Oh, blimey.
What would you have?
I had... I'll tell you exactly what I had. I had one of the Tesco's 100% beef burgers.
Yeah.
No nice. Bun. No bun.
Yeah.
With onions.
Yeah.
And some couscous.
Nice.
I love couscous, boy.
I don't like couscous.
I didn't think you did.
I like Tic Tacs.
Do you like couscous, boy? You tasted it?
Yeah, of course I have.
Oh, you have?
Yeah.
Not a lover?
Not a lover. Not for me. Well, I won't go to fucking McDonald's for my fucking wedding reception, though.
You like McDonald's, though?
I do like McDonald's, yeah, but I wouldn't fucking go to
McDonald's.
Whatever the fuck it is, these cunts have gone there for their wedding reception.
Yeah, I don't blame them.
Blame
I do like my Burger King though. I do like a Burger King double whopper with cheese. Angus. Double Angus burger. Oh, there you're talking.
Yeah?
Yeah. I like the dip. I like my hummus.
So are you?
Got a hummus?
No, I don't like hummus. Fish in it, hummus?
No.
What is it?
Chickpeas.
Yeah, that's it. What are they? Chickpeas.
It's beautiful. It's a dip. It's a the chickpeas are mixed with
looks like puke.
Lemon. No, it doesn't look like puke.
Looks like fucking somebody just puked up and said, "Here, I have that." It's fucking some Greek cunt.
Terry Zalata.
That's what looks like puke.
It's pink.
Yeah, that's not the colour of a food. Pink? What the fuck's that come from?
It's fish.
Ugh.
It's beautiful.
Looks like some Greek cunt's puked up and said, "Hey, Giorgio, go and sell that in the restaurant," and I have, and it's caught on. Try some fucking music out there.
Tell you. seeing under the stars above. Yes, I would. I like to see more.
Stevie Wonder! Probably at his very best there.
Boogie on, reggae woman.
Well,
and before that, Neil Young and Crazy Horse and Cinnamon Girl. That's the type of girls I like. In a cinnamon bun.
Oh, yeah. Boogie on, reggae woman.
Suck my big fat dick. Boogie on, reggae woman.
Get me balls to be lick.
I laughed at it.
Quite right, you turned on.
I laughed.
Well, YouTube's working on here.
Huh?
YouTube's working fine on here.
What?
YouTube's working fine on here.
Good for you, pal.
Well, I'm just telling you, you cunt.
Well.
Spunking right in my big balls.
Here we go, we've got... Deirdre's photo case,
but
day one.
That means we're starting to wind down.
It's a bird in a bed with a white bra on. Nice looking silk.
Have a look.
I hate lying here listening to mum cry, but I hate having to go and comfort her too. She goes in to comfort her mum. Please don't cry, mum. I promise you'd be better off without Dad. I wish you'd believe me. Oh, Teresa, you always say that, but I just feel so old and unloved. I can't help it.
Teresa?
She's on the phone now with her friend. What? Still in her bra. I don't know how to cheer mum up anymore. Do you think I should ask her to come out with us? Cut to her mate in a little floral dress. Sure, why not? Let's get her drunk. She can let her out there for once. It'll be really funny. Oh, we know where this is leading, don't we? We know where this is leading. Could be a fucking mother and daughter fucking coming on.
Yes! One of my personals. One of my personals for many a year.
One of your personal faves?
Flying around. It's been flying around for many a year, but at least 20.
I don't think it is. I think what's going to happen is she's going to nick her boyfriend or something.
Something like that. Or both of the fence in the same geezer.
She's going to come in and find him fucking her mum.
Good.
Violently from behind.
Oh, yeah.
Hope Powell remembers drunken night of sex. I had sex 3 times in a night with a friend. We were just using one another, but I have not been able to stop thinking about him. I'm a single girl of 20, and there's this guy who works down the chip shop who swears his Elvis. No, there's this guy about 4 years older who I talk to on Facebook and see him from time to time. We see ran into one another at a birthday party, and we all had a lot to drink. I went back to his place afterwards instead of home because he lived nearby. We flopped down on the sofa and he poured more drinks. Then he put his arm around me and started to very gradually to undress me.
Good boy.
His hands were everywhere.
That's it.
But it felt okay, and I just let him get on with it.
That's it.
We moved into his bed and had full sex.
Good boy.
A while later, we did it again.
Yep.
And then again, we woke up in the morning. After that, we just said our goodbyes, and that was it.
Mm-hmm.
The thing is, he is constantly on my mind. I think I'm scared to tell him because my feelings are so strong. I know it was just casual sex, and he may not have given it another thought. I am frightened of rejection after what was just a boozy, sexy night.
Well,
Deirdre says, well, get round there, gal. Get on your knees and start sucking again. Because that's the only way he's going to be reminded of it.
Right.
On the knees, arse in the air,
yep,
saying, here it is, big boy. And then you'll find out whether it's casual sex or he wants something more.
And ask him if his mates want to join in, quite rightly so.
Mm. Every right to.
Because you are one big slag. Remember that. You're a fucking whore. And you love it.
Although I'm very happily engaged to a wonderful man, I keep dreaming about my ex. I'm 32 and due to be married, but for months I have felt drained by these dreams. They disturb me and make me think about my ex during the day too. He did not treat me well, although in my dreams he is perfect.
Yeah, okay.
In real life, he's still that awful person who broke my heart. Yeah, I keep wondering if he thinks about me too. I even checked him out on Facebook. Deirdre says, well, I'll tell you what, love, why don't you get married and still keep fucking getting stuck by the ex?
Yeah.
You get the best of both worlds then. You get married, you have the security of the mug who's married you, and you still get a big old fucking bill going right up your fucking...
That's what she means. She means she misses the big cock.
Going up your little tuck pipe. So, that's their advice there.
Oh. Slags all.
My partner texts me to say she was at a friend's house. Something didn't feel right, so I went to check and found her at the house of a guy she'd admitted kissing a while before. She is 24, I'm 26. We've known one another since our teens. I'm so in love with her. It's become unhealthy.
Yeah.
She admitted kissing this other man a month ago, but I forgave her. She was out last week and texted me as usual at the end of the evening to let me know she was safe.
Mm-hmm.
She said she was at a friend's house, but it didn't feel right. Yeah, you said that, you cunt.
Prick.
I got up and went round to the pal's place. I texted her saying, look, out of the window. She wouldn't, so I went to where the guy she had kissed lives. Well, obviously, she wouldn't look out the window, you cunt, because she wasn't there.
Prick.
And refused to leave until she showed herself, which she did. She now says she wants some space, but it's like I'm addicted to her. I keep showing up at hers, even though she wants me to leave her alone.
Oh, dear.
Deirdre says, you fucking dodgy, stalking cunt. She don't fucking like you. She thinks you're a cunt.
She's made it perfect. She's tried to be nice about it and keep it from you and not make it too hurt. You fucking decided to go AWOL and fucking start stalking the cunt. Well, you're going to have no more fucking problems, aren't you? You weak, 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 weak cunt.
Yeah. In the words of Chris Gilbert, man up.
Man up, you cunt. Sit back and shut up.
Man up.
And man up, Chris Gilbert.
Just man up, for God's sake.
God almighty, eh?
You weird fucking cunt. Don't fucking go round, don't turn up round her. You'll be fucking inside before you know it, you fucking weird bastard.
Cunt.
I'm sending you a leaflet on fucking Stop Being a Weird Cunt by Deirdre. And if you're not, I'm going to come round and cut your bollocks off.
Right.
She's gone strong there, but...
Oh.
You know.
Very, very strong. Strong stuff from Deirdre.
But, you know.
She's right.
She's right.
The bird's always right. No wonder she writes from the sun.
Don't mess with Deirdre.
No wonder she fucking... Ah, she's a bastard bird.
She's Deirdre, mate. I don't mean Deirdre Barlow.
No!
She's having to come to terms with her husband being a fucking nonce.
Who is?
Deirdre Barlow.
Oh, I haven't seen it.
You mean you haven't seen it? You know Ken Barlow's up for fucking...
Oh, in real life, you were sorry. Yeah. Of course.
Well, in my world, I'm a bit confused between the both of them. I think Ken Barlow's up for fucking nonsense. But not William Roach.
William Roach, he's a guy. What's happened to him, William Roach?
Huh?
What's happened to him?
Well, we've got it all to look forward to, haven't we? It's exciting.
Oh, it's coming, it's coming.
But Willie Roach in the cult. We've got the other one from Coronation Street in cult. Why don't they just move the fucking studios to the fucking cult?
Willie Roach. Yeah, who's that other one?
Michael Lee Vale.
Yeah, who played Kevin Webster?
Yeah. They just fucking want to move the old Granada studios to the cult room, don't they? Then they can kill two birds with one stone.
I mean, they
They can bring back Crown Court and have Coronation Street as well.
Loved it. Crown Court, brilliant.
These are real cases.
They were. They were real cases, yeah. First of its kind, that.
Yeah, well, you know what I watched today, and... Oh, I can never tire of it, son. I never tire of it.
Go on.
Oh, it's
go on.
Theo.
Eh?
It's Kojak.
Oh, damn.
I'm re-loving my love for Kojak.
Yeah,
all
me
over
too.
Again.
Oh.
All over it. I'm shouting at the telly. When today Adele's friend got killed and she come in, she was crying and Theo put his arm around her and I went, that's a Theo! That's a caring Theo!
Oh, it's a caring Theo. Oh, Theo!
Oh, I love that man. Oh. You don't know what we're talking about. We're talking about Kojak.
What about one the other day? One the other day was a classic. Oh, when it's a bad cop.
No, he don't like a bad cop.
Hey,
because he go
right on his nose as well.
Yeah.
He was. But see that one?
Didn't see it, but I could imagine.
Right on his schnuzzle. And he likes him as well. I like that one, he likes him.
Yeah.
Oh, he gives it to him at the end, though.
He won't have no dirty cup on his
face. And he gives him that Theo look at the end. You've upset the man. Don't upset Theo.
I loved it today because Frank come in. I went, I want you to do this, Theo. And Theo went, hey, baby, it's just a hunch. I got a hunch. And he went, oh, I want you to do it, Theo. That's a hunch, Frank. I got a hunch. He kept going, I want you to do it. And he looked at him and went, you and your hunches.
Yeah.
And let him get away with it. You don't tell Theo what to do. He tells you what to do.
Yeah. Oh, Theo.
Oh, it's 3 o'clock on ITV4, but they repeat it at 10 o'clock on ITV4 in the mornings.
In the mornings, yeah.
That's the one I'm catching.
Oh, you're catching that one?
Yeah.
And of course, we love for Magnum's come back as well. I do love a bit of Magnum PI. Oh, he's no Theo, son.
But who is a Theo? He's no coacher. But talking about first of its kind, I feel that was the first of its... I don't know if it was.
It was gritty, wasn't it?
It was very gritty, and it was filmed bang on location in
New
York.
Oh, yeah, it's all New York. That one with Harvey Keitel was brilliant.
I don't know if it was the first one to do that. In America, they were probably doing that before, but...
I think things like...
But I think Kojak influenced the things like the Sweeney...
Yeah... Streets of San Francisco, before Kojak,
yeah.
And that was a bang on location.
Yeah,
that's another good program.
Well, it wasn't as gritty as Theo.
No, nothing was quite as gritty as Theo. I mean, the Nelson murders, wasn't it?
Yeah,
the Marcus Nelson murders.
Yeah,
it was a good. It was a film.
Yeah, that's good.
It was very good.
No, it was good. Good
that
as a film, in its
as
own
a
own
film in its own right. And that introduced Kojak, didn't it?
Yeah. I mean, no stopping him after that.
No. Oh, was it till about 80, 1989, 79?
Yeah, something like that.
He did some new ones in the late 80s, but weren't very good.
No.
That's when Crocker came. I think Crocker... Well, if you watched him now, they'd be all right.
Yeah, probably. Just see how, wouldn't it?
Because he was only 70 when he died.
Yeah.
So he didn't really look old and haggard.
Well, he never looked old and haggard, did he, really?
No, well, they don't, do they?
Bald people don't.
No.
Good-looking man, Telly Savalas. Better look than his fucking brother, put it that way.
Okay, Lieutenant.
Oh, bless. He thought, I've got to get this fucking camera job somewhere. Must have been a burden round his fucking neck.
But he loved him, didn't he? He loved George. He loved George Savalas.
Oh, we know a lot about Theo, people.
Theo, son.
We know a bit too much about Kojak for our own liking.
We used to wake him with Wednesday nights.
Yep, 3 o'clock in the morning.
3 in the morning.
Used to wake up for it.
3 in the morning. Yeah. We should stay over at yours for a Theo fest. Now we used to tape him for some reason. Oh, yeah, we did. We did tape them.
Yeah, we did tape them as well. Wish I could find them old tapes with them on them. And then a video recorder to watch them on.
I haven't got a video recorder anymore. I've got one here. One here that's in the...
That's it.
We used it for the video security. I used an old video cassette.
Yeah.
That goes 24 hours, blah, blah, blah. You have to keep changing it.
Yeah, you got security
here? Well, no one uses it.
Where is it?
What?
No, I just want to.
Where's you walk in?
I've never seen it.
When you walk to the front door, look up to you.
Is it going, though?
Yeah.
Where does it go to? Well, I mean, where's it?
When my mum's got some, you know, where the immersion heater is.
Yeah.
It's there.
What, that's like a little monitor?
See, monitors, yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. It was originally put there because my mum had suspicions of people used to turning up here at different times of the morning where I used to go and get my drugs. But I doctored it every time.
Well, people would turn up here?
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
How did you doctor it?
Well, I'd stop the tape.
Oh, right.
And then go get them, come back and restart it again. Yeah.
Clever.
Yeah. No. Used to do it, really. Then go back, rewind a bit where I'd just been, you see me coming out to get it. Tape over it.
Clever stuff.
Well, I had to do some.
Well, you had to get your drugs, didn't you?
I did.
Nothing could stop you getting your drugs.
What a crazy time they were.
Well, you got them. Everyone's happy. Except your mum.
She wasn't happy. She was never happy, Sam. Oh, was she calling a taser, we?
Yeah.
I think we had enough, haven't we?
We had enough.
My foot hurts. Oh, we had a good one today. Enjoyed our little chat. We had a good chat today, me and you.
Oh, yeah.
Not that anyone else is bothered.
Yeah, not that anybody else is.
I want to find out what's wrong with this thing as well. What the fuck is that?
I have not got a clue.
So that's all we can say to you. Thanks very much for listening tonight, folks.
Yeah, thanks a lot.
Monday night. Might have tomorrow,
see how we feel.
And happy trails to you.
Happy trails to everybody out there.
Happy trails to you until we meet again. Happy trails to you. Keep keep smiling until then. Who cares about the clouds if we're together? Just sing a song and bring the sunny weather. Happy trails to you till we meet again. Some trails are happy ones, others are blue. It's the way you ride that trail that counts. Here's a happy one for you. Happy trails to you until we meet again. Happy trails to you. Keep smiling until then. Who cares about the clouds if we're together? Just sing a song and bring the sunny weather. Happy trails to you till we meet again. Happy trails to you till we meet again.
Oi, the Pope. You gay-loving bastard.